Flow noise is a major issue in pneumatic systems, contributing to noise pollution. In this video, you'll learn how to calculate the sound pressure level of flow noise using the Foulkes-Williams-Hawkins equation in ONSI's Fluent. This method is used for calculating noise in free field conditions. I'll walk you through a transient solution, enabling the Foulkes-Williams-Hawkins equation, defining four microphones, and adding a permeable surface to capture the noise. Before we begin, I'd like to explain the modeling steps and the Foulkes-Williams-Hawkins theory. Let's get started. Hello, I'm Armin. Welcome to my channel. I recommend checking out my videos to enhance your skills in ONSI's and COMSOL. And don't forget to like and subscribe for more content. Let's get started. A pneumatic muffler, also known as a pneumatic silencer, is a device used to reduce the noise generated by air exhaust in pneumatic systems. The muffler's purpose is to reduce this noise by diffusing the air and decreasing the speed at which it escapes, thereby minimizing the sound level. The Foulkes-Williams-Hawkins is a famous method for aeroacoustics noise prediction generated by objects moving through a fluid, such as air. It is commonly applied in analyzing noise from aircraft, propellers, wind turbines, and exhaust systems. In the Foulkes-Williams-Hawkins model, permeable and impermeable surfaces are used to integrate sound sources. A permeable surface allows fluid to pass through and captures noise from sources within the fluid. In contrast, an impermeable surface, like a solid body, for example, an aircraft wing, does not allow fluid to pass and focuses on the sound generated by pressure fluctuations on the surface, simplifying the analysis by excluding noise from the surrounding fluid. These two photos illustrate how to integrate sound sources using both permeable and impermeable methods. Large eddy simulation, or LES, excels in simulating turbulent flows and noise, making it the best choice for aeroacoustic analysis. A very fine mesh is needed to capture detailed turbulent scales. Due to the fine mesh and turbulence modeling, LES is resource-intensive. Detached eddy simulation, or DES, combines RANS for steady regions and LES for turbulence, offering a balance between accuracy and efficiency. DES needs a fine mesh, but it's less demanding than LES. The time step and total solution time are crucial factors that significantly impact the results. The maximum frequency is determined by the Nyquist criterion. For example, with a time step of 50 microseconds, the maximum frequency is 10,000 Hz. Additionally, the total solution time influences the frequency resolution. For instance, a total time of 0.1 seconds results in a frequency resolution of 10 Hz. Now that we've covered the necessary explanations, let's dive into the modeling. In this tutorial, we'll begin by adding a fluid flow with Fluent meshing system. To do this, I'll simply drag and drop it into the project schematic. Next, let's add the geometry. I will import the air muffler geometry by right-clicking on Geometry and choose it from my computer. Now, I'd like to prepare the geometry using Space Claim. While you can also prepare geometry using Discovery, both have the same process. In Space Claim, I will add two domains and assign names for the boundary conditions. Here we have the geometry of the air muffler. Before we proceed, it's advisable to adjust the coordinate system because I will specify the positions of the microphones around the muffler, and the distance of the microphones is determined by this coordinate system. In the structure tree, I'll select the air muffler and choose the move option. I will change the coordinates of the muffler by using an anchor to position it at the desired location. Next, I'll click on Up To and select the origin. Now, the muffler is correctly positioned in the coordinate system. Moving on, we need to define a free field domain that represents the environment. I will navigate to the Design tab and select Sphere. Additionally, I'll hide the air muffler to prevent it from merging with the sphere. A diameter of 1 meter is sufficient. I'll click on the origin and enter a value of 1,000 millimeters, which is adequate for our needs. Please note that the flow should not hit the surface of the sphere. If this occurs after solving, the diameter should be increased. At this point, we need to split the sphere because we only require a hemisphere for CFD purposes. I'll make the air muffler visible again and add a plane for the split. I will add a plane and click on the inlet of the air muffler. Now, let's proceed by splitting the body using the combine tool and then deleting half of the sphere. I'll change the name of the hemisphere to outer domain. I assume that the air muffler body is rigid, so I will subtract it from the outer domain. As before, I'll subtract it from the hemisphere using the combine tool. Everything looks correct now. We only need the fluid domain. Let's take a look inside the domain. We can see the walls of the air muffler within the domain. It's a good idea to extrude the inlet by 10 millimeters, as this will allow us to easily apply boundary conditions later on. This geometry is set up for the impermeable Fowkes-Williams-Hawkins method, but I want to use the permeable theory, so we need to create a permeable surface. We need a permeable surface to capture acoustic fluctuations. It's better to add another sphere. First, I will delete this plane because we don't need it. I will hide all parts and click on Sphere from Design tab. Then I will add a small sphere. For example, a diameter of 300 millimeters is enough. As before, I will delete half of the sphere. Now we have a small semisphere inside the acoustic domain. It's also better to rename the smaller semisphere, so let's call it the permeable surface. We can rename each part by double-clicking on its name. We need to subtract the smaller domain from the larger domain. For this, we can use the split body tool. It wasn't a good choice, so I will press Ctrl plus C to undo. We should use the combine tool to subtract it. Two new parts have been added to the structure tree because they were separated from the larger domain. We need to delete the redundant parts. Make sure to check all parts and identify the redundant ones. I've checked all the parts. Yes. These two domains were merged, so I will combine them and rename the new part as inner domain. The geometry is now prepared. We also need to name the inlet, outlet, and walls. I'll start with the inlet. I will select the air muffler inlet, and from the selection window, hit on Create Name Selection. Inlet is a suitable name. The surface of the hemisphere will be the outlet. I'll hit on Create an S and type Outlet. Now, I want to select the air muffler walls, so I'll hide the other surfaces. I will select all the wall surfaces and add a name selection. Be careful not to select the inlet. Same as before, I will click on Create Name Selection. Everything looks correct. Now I will unhide all parts. Since this is an aeroacoustics model, we don't need the muffler geometry in the simulation, so I'll suppress it. This model consists of a smaller domain, or the permeable surface in a larger domain, or the environment domain. I don't need the plane, so I can delete it. One final step remains. We must couple the two domains using shared topology. I will click on the Workbench tab, and then click the green checkmark. As you can see, the two domains are now coupled. I will close Space Claim. It's time to generate mesh for the model. Now, we need to double-click on the mesh. Make sure to check the double precision option and enter the number of processors. Finally, I will hit on start. This is the watertight workflow. I will set up all the mesh options in this section step by step. First, I need to import the geometry, so I will click on the Import Geometry. After a short time, the geometry is imported. As you can see, the geometry contains only the fluid domain. I want to set the mesh size on the walls and the small hemisphere domain, so I'll choose Yes. I'd like to set 0.4 mm surface size for walls and hit on Add Local Sizing. I also want to set a body size for the inner domain. I'll change face size to body size from this option, and I think 4 mm will be enough. I'll hit on Add Local Sizing again. In the Generate the Surface Mesh, I want to change the minimum size to 0.5 mm and leave the default settings. The surface mesh has been generated, but we encountered a warning because the skewness is too high. To fix this, I need to reduce the skewness. I will right-click on the surface mesh, select Improve Surface. Set the face quality limit to 0.6, then click Improve Surface Mesh. The smaller the number, the better. Now, the skewness is down to 0.58. In the Describe Geometry step, we can see the geometry type. The model only consists of fluid domains, so we need to select the second option. The two domains are coupled, and there shouldn't be a wall between them, so we need to change the wall to internal. Finally, I'm going to click on Describe Geometry. Now, it's time to adjust the boundary conditions. The boundary conditions are set automatically, but we can change them if needed. Here, we have a velocity inlet, a pressure outlet, and walls. Everything looks correct, so I'll click on Update Boundaries. We can see the two fluid domains here. It looks correct, so I will update it. Next, I will adjust the boundary layer thickness. I'll change the number of layers to 5, as additional layers can better resolve turbulent flow. And I will leave the other settings as default. I also want to generate a polyhex core volume mesh for all domains, so I'll select that option here. By default, the polyhex core mesh is non-conformal, but we can change avoid 1/8 octree transition to yes to generate a conformal mesh. The mesh generation is complete, and although some stair-stepping occurred, it's not a significant concern. In the console, we can also check the mesh quality and the number of cells. The mesh quality is acceptable since there are no errors flagged. Also, the mesh is conformal. As you can see, 5 layers have been generated along the walls, and everything appears to be in order. Now, I'll close this window. Watch the rest of the modeling in part 2. Thank you.